I've been pretty astonished to learn how much textbooks vary from state to state. There's this famous saying that history is written by the victors, but in the case of the United States, that's actually not entirely true. As someone who went to public school my entire life, I started reflecting on some of the things that I was taught in school and even starting to question some of them. Education is the foundation of a society, so it's understandable that there's going to be a lot of voices that are going to want to play a role in shaping it. I did some digging, and I found a New York Times article that compared the history textbooks of California and Texas. Now, to produce a textbook, first there's a standard national edition that's written, and then the states and the districts are each sent them to review, and then they make their own revisions according to local standards. Let's take a look at some of the differences they spotted. White flight. The textbooks sometimes offer different explanations for the challenges of upward mobility in Black communities. California attributes it to white flight and housing discrimination. According to Texas, it's not only just racism, but also because reforms led to higher taxes. When it comes to LGBTQ issues, Texas mostly focuses on recent issues like the AIDS epidemic. California's LGBTQ history goes far earlier, like this example where the role of non-binary gender identities within Native American tribes is mentioned in California textbooks, but not covered in the Texas edition. In the California edition, the immigration section contains this long excerpt from a novel about a Dominican American family, the stated purpose being to share the experience of growing up as the child of immigrants. Now, that same section in the Texas edition includes excerpts from a Border Patrol agent, a Vietnamese immigrant, and a second-generation Mexican-American, their stated purpose being for students to analyze both legal and illegal immigration to the U.S. Overall, it appears that conservative states have fought for schools to promote patriotism, highlight the influence of Christianity, and celebrate the founding fathers, while blue states, they typically like to emphasize bottom-up activism, focusing on the personal experiences of enslaved peoples, women, minority groups, and immigrants. After reading this, it is not surprising at all to me that our country is so divided politically and that we have a hard time even agreeing on what truth is. I know firsthand how difficult it can be to teach history from a neutral perspective. It is impossible to cover everything, and we all have our own biases and items that we want to prioritize. When I'm creating my videos, I try to avoid my own bias by using primary sources. According to this article, a lot of history teachers do this as well. For what it's worth, my advice to you guys would be to seek out as many sources and perspectives that you can. Find voices that you trust, but also look for opposing arguments and develop the skills and the tools to be able to decipher information, separate fact from fiction, and form your own analysis. Develop these skills early because they're going to be super helpful for you for the rest of your life.